Hi everybody, I'm Jeff McKnight here with Aaron Nagel. Again, I guess tonight I can talk correctly. Last time I fumbled the introduction. So, I'm gonna leave it.
You had a numb tongue last week.
I had a numb tongue, yes. My tongue was numb. So, anyway,
apparently after they injected your tongue for that appointment, it had some effect for a while.
They're not going to inject me from my tongue. They're going to inject me and...
I'm not talking about that.
Cut me open for my hernia.
I'm talking about last week's incision on the tongue to numb it.
Probably. Because
you couldn't speak.
I know. So, anyway, what's been going on lately then? For the week, you had your... cast member party, one person showed up, I heard.
So this is the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers mini movie weekly wrap up for the 26th of June, 2011. And yes, Jeff is correct. Yesterday afternoon was our cast meeting. And boy, we had a full house. Just me and one of our main stars, Carlene Macedo, playing Kimberly. That's it.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, she has a YouTube video, like another YouTube video that she did for some project. It's kind of interesting. So, I'm definitely glad I checked that out. It's kind of weird and mysterious. So far she's the most dedicated person in the entire cast, other than of course me, the producer. Which I have to be dedicated, or the movie won't follow through. Mm. So in the next cast meeting, we're going to have... it's probably going to be on a Sunday, where he's actually there. And then when we get closer to the production, we're going to start doing production meetings, which means producers, casting directors, directors, everybody's going to be there, the cast, the crew, even the minor speaking roles. So you're going to have like 20, 25 people for the production meetings. But just the cast meetings are just like the main guys, just like the Power Rangers themselves, and then we'll have our production meetings that involve everybody. So that'll be something closer to when we start doing our script readings and everything like that. Speaking of which, I'm still working on the script and scenes. So Jeff, can you tell them about Lord the Moose opening scene? Give them a brief overview.
I mean, I could just make it where he's like. Waking up out of a hibernation sleep. I don't know if we're still gonna go with that one.
That's basically all we've got right now. Is just Lord Demuth comes in. There he is. End of scene.
He's there, and I'll be using my voice effects on.
That's about all we can really give away right now. We can't really give away too much. What the hell are you doing?
Flipping things.
We really can't give away too much information on that because we don't want to give away the whole.
Yeah, we're not gonna give away the whole movie, but we're just giving you little bits and pieces of what we think we could do. And then, yeah, the actual creation of the movie is the more spectacular part in the movie. So just like creating music or. Creating just basically what you're interested in or your YouTube videos and stuff like that. So, it's the creation is the whole creative process and what people go through, and I think that's what makes the magical moments of the movies and YouTube videos pretty cool. Have you given any more thought, Aaron, as to storyboarding on what you want to do? You want to work on my guy.
I'm just going scene by scene, so, I mean, there's that scene, and then we gotta go cut to the teenagers.
Yeah.
As they say, so, we'll see what happens there, but I'll just have to find that out, but yeah, we talked about that, the shooting schedule, and, stuff, and, she actually, hung out and watched an episode of Power Rangers to get an idea. I wanted her to study, Kimberly's character, so, she can kind of get an idea of, you know, how to act out her character when we go to start filming and stuff.
Yeah.
And then, kind of watch her, study her in combat when they fight, in the fighting scene. So when we choreograph a fight, you can kind of get an idea of, like, a Kimberly-esque fighting sequence. So
yeah, well,
that's what I'm asking everybody to do in this film. Like, everybody who's playing a Power Ranger, study the character that they are portraying, and study them hard. I'm studying Jason like nothing else.
Yeah,
he's
I'm
like my
download.
Favorite Power Ranger, so I study him like nothing else, and so I follow all his stuff pretty closely. But
yeah, I'm gonna end up downloading the Power Rangers series, and then
he keeps saying that, but he never does it.
I will. I finally got Aeon Flux, man. So that shows you like I have a different genre of sci-fi that I watch.
But that's a good one.
Aeon
Flux,
finally.
Power Rangers is
I
more.
Found the right one.
So
yeah, different ones.
But
on there. I was worried about that.
Oh, there goes the birdie. That means it is prop time. Our prop segment of the show. Jeff, we got only one prop this week, right?
Yeah, we got my cat.
Yeah, we bought a cat.
No, you got the blue. And you got the blue wristwatch. I'm not wearing the blue wristwatch. That's
here
not
is
my
the
watch.
The prop that I received.
The blue communicator.
Actually, earlier today, Billy's communicator. But what I found funky about it is, you know how the other communicators, they have the little clip thing here that goes through and snaps over. It doesn't have a thing to go through the slot and come around and snap in.
Aaron's been having some technical difficulty with putting the watches.
No, it's just this one. I got my other ones to work, but it's missing a little clip that goes into this thing.
I showed you how to do that.
Right. Let's see you try it. That little clip part that they have on the other ones is missing, so you can't get it to go through right.
Did it break off or what?
No, it came that way.
Wait. Remember, I think it goes underneath, man.
Yeah, but there's supposed to be a little clip that clips in that kind of hooks onto that bar. It can't really hook onto anything because there's no hook there.
Man, you got a bogus one.
It's all right. There's other ways we can tape it. There's other ways we can do it. It's not my character, so I'm not too concerned about it. There's always a way to improvise. If we need tape or duct tape, something will work. I mean, it's gonna be on the lower part of the wrist, so no one's gonna be looking and notice. But you know, no need wasting the show time by fiddling with the stupid communicator.
Well, I'm gonna try and get it to snap in, but if it's
let's do that when the show's over, because we're I mean
if it's already it's, damaged, then it's a bogus one. You gotta send it back to him. Hopefully,
so we just got the blue communicator at this point, and the Black Ranger helmet is gonna be coming soon. I got about one more week to go, and then Sushaya should be sending that out. And then I've got one other prop that I told people on the prop show for Tommy that I'm researching. So that I'm not going to tell you what that is. You guys will just have to find out. I will be getting another prop here middle of the week, so a couple more days. So I think everything's shaping up pretty nicely. Just going to have to see how this communicator works, but
I think I can figure it out.
If he can figure it out, we're all good. But any last comments that you have before we end up the show today?
Yeah, I still have to get my helmet. It was third episode. I said I've had to get my helmet, so and it will happen sooner or later. Aaron's getting some stuff taken care of, like I said.
All right,
not picked mine out.
Aaron Ale, Jeff McKnight, signing off. We'll see you next week. Later, peace. People. We'll be right back.